Hello?
Is this Ms. Nelson?
Yes, it is.
Ms. Nelson, my name is Roy Mercer. I'm calling you from down here to Broken Bow.
Oh, hi.
Howdy. Listen, I got a hold of one of y'all's newsletters, one of y'all's OWOA newsletters.
Oh, yes. Uh-huh.
Yeah, I got a Christmas tree farm down here, about an acre of Scotch pines and spruces and such.
Uh-huh, wonderful.
And they got infested with them beetles that you's talking about in your newsletter.
The Ips beetle?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, and I followed your advice and sprayed them things with herbicides, and it killed all my trees.
Oh, wait a minute. I never gave any advice about spraying with herbicide. Herbicide is a tree killer. I mean...
Well, maybe you had a misprint in your letter, because that's what it said, some herbicide.
No. Okay, wait a minute.
I got some Scotch pines. They're supposed to be some folks' Christmas trees come December, and I ain't got a dang on one of them.
Oh, God. Okay, all right, first place. The bulletin stated that you can't even spray an Ips beetle infestation with insecticide because they live under the bark, okay? So spraying won't do them any good. And my bulletin,
I guarantee it won't. It killed mine.
Well, yeah, if you used a herbicide.
Well, I just following the instructions in your dadgum bulletin. Don't
no.
y'all research them things out? Don't you know what to happen if you spray them trees with that stuff?
Yeah, I sure do. And I would never... No, there was no misprint. Okay, wait a minute. Let's think about this. You have...
We can make this real easy if you just write me out a check. Because I lost, I figure, around 120 trees. And okay. Come Christmas time, I usually get about $50 a piece for them.
Okay, well, how big were your trees?
It's about 8 foot, 6 to 8 foot.
Oh, my Lord.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Do you know what kind of herbicide you use? Because most herbicides don't kill pine.
It's whatever it was in that bulletin. I don't know what you'd said in there.
But I never said herbicide.
Well, I took it down to the co-op, and they gave me what they thought was right.
Oh, my Lord.
I got about $6,000 in lost income I'm going to have to try to make up. And I'm retired. I supplement it with, you know, guiding fishing trips here and there time to time. But
well, sure.
If you just make me out a check, I guarantee you I just forget the whole thing.
Okay, wait a minute. Okay, first place, we are a nonprofit organization of woodland owners, okay? And our main purpose is protection of private property rights and education of woodland owners so people don't make mistakes like you just made. And I take it you're not a member.
Well, my main purpose is to try to keep, you know, everything afloat here and keep my family, you know, took care of.
Oh, well, sure. I understand that, Mr. Mercer.
Yeah, we ain't going to have any Christmas money this year.
Mr. Mercer, if you read that
bulletin...
I'll
probably get my wife have to braid a lock of her hair into a watch fob for me.
What?
Well, I guarantee you we'd have to make crafts or something because we ain't got no money to buy no presents or won't when it comes time.
Oh, listen, I'm sorry. I don't mean to laugh, but I cannot envision anyone... spraying an acre of pines with herbicide and expecting that to kill the Ips beetle.
Well,
okay.
can you envision an ass whooping? Because that's what it's going to come down to if I don't get some satisfaction out of this thing.
Okay, now hold it, Jack. You don't know who you're talking to.
Well, I ain't usually one to whoop a woman's ass, but my wife...
Oh, well, don't let that get in your way.
My wife's pretty tore up about it. I might send her down there.
Go ahead. You'd never find me. I'm down in the Kiamichi Mountains, but I'll tell you what, you give me your address, and I'll meet you at the damn gate.
By God. You give me your address, and I'll send her down there.
Well,
with about a truckload full
will,
of...
And I'll tell you what, I'll do more than that. She'd never be able to find it. I'll meet her up on the damn highway.
Well,
now,
by
listen.
God, when? When can you be there?
You just pack yourself a lunch and come on down. I'll wait for you.
She'll be down there. I'd probably have to drive her.
Look, all right, wait a minute. Okay, let's talk about this rationally. You've got an acre of trees that you sprayed with herbicide that are dead, okay?
That's what it looks like. They're brown.
Right. All right. I don't know why you sprayed them with herbicide because the bulletin... I didn't say that. I said...
Listen, if you just make me out a check about $6,000, I believe that just about pay my student loan off. You could make it out to Mark Nelson if you would.
What?
He'd pay his student loan off old Mark Nelson. He'd pay his
Your
loan.
Son's
Mark Nelson's my son.
He's pulling a joke on you.
Lord of mercy.
Pat.
What?
It's a joke.
Pat, this is Phil and Brent and Roy Mercer from up here in Tulsa, Oklahoma. How are you?
Yeah!
Are you rat?
Oh, pack a lunch, Pat, and come whoop her ass.
Oh, you darn right I was going to. I tell you what, I can lift a 50-pound feed bag now, no problem. So I can take anybody.
Believe me, Pat, we don't want to tangle with you.
I guarantee you, we're quivering in our wading boots right now.
I'll tell you what. In fact, Mark Nelson better be quivering because I'm going to whip somebody's butt for sure when I catch up with that boy.
What the hell's he going to school for that's costing him $6,000?
Well, he went to TU.
Well, so what'd he go, about 2 weeks?
Yeah. Well, he darn sure won't be able to go anywhere for a while when I catch up with him. I don't believe this.
Oh, my Lord.